Hey everybody, we are at the bird sanctuary located on Beaver Lakes property in North Asheville. We're gonna take a little walk, but here, this is what you can do to help have birds in your yard. You can explore their garden. They have all these birds here and they show you throughout the walk all the birds that are in here. And tells you why things are important and climate change to birds. And it shows this one, climate change for it. One of our favorite year-round residents at Beaver Lake Bird Sanctuary is a serious risk due to climate change. According to the 2014 Audubon Birds and Climate Change Report, the brown-headed nuthatch is predicted to lose 95% of its summer range, shown in the green, by 2080. That's sad. It's going to lose a lot of places to go. All right, we're going to walk. The walk is on this nice wooden kind of patio area throughout the whole place. And there are these nice signs, like I was saying, that tell you all about it. And we always go to the right. There's a nice view of the lake when we get to the end. And here are some birds that they have here, including a turkey. Blah, 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 blah. We're definitely going on this little route we go. We're going to see marshes and pond edges and grassy fields. We'll see those. Of course, tree limbs. All right, so enjoy the walk with us, please. It's a nice windy day, so you may see some of these tall grasses blowing around. The weather today is perfect for August. It is just, you couldn't beat it. I don't know what kind of bird feeder that is, but it feeds some special bird. They have all kinds of bird feeders throughout here. But that guy is really interesting. Looks like a chimney. Maybe bats go in it. I don't know. Do you know, Troy?
No.
I've seen quite a bit of wildlife through here, especially like frogs and turtles when we get towards our little stopping point. But the birds I've only heard because they fly so fast. Right here, if we were to get down and onto the ground, it's just dirt. But in a minute, we would definitely not want to get down. It's that marshy stuff I was telling you about. There's a little place we can sit if we wanted to just chill out and talk. But we're going to continue on. Okay, that is what I'm looking at right now. Starting to get kind of marshy over through there. Oh yeah, Troy was just telling me a ghost story about Beaver Lake. So I'll let him tell us when we get to the end, and he can put it on this video. So make sure you watch till the end. Make sure you also like and subscribe. You won't get any notifications unless you hit that bell too. So make sure you hit the bell. Speaking of marshes, there's some yucky water over there, but lots of turtles and frogs are, I don't know what else creatures are in there, but it's gross. So just gonna keep on till we find the lake. Oh, here's some more of that water. You can see little things moving in the water, but no frogs right now. Or turtles. Keep your eye open in our video in the background because I can't keep my eye everywhere. Let me know if you see anything. There might be a fox or a squirrel or a rabbit or something out here. I'm sorry. Did we disturb you? Oh no, they're neat. Stay and look. That man was watching a dragonfly. I think they're pretty nifty. All right, we made it to the little edge of the lake where we like to sit and talk and do whatever. Bring your lunch if you want, I guess. This goes from yucky marshlands that also have a bird feeder of some sort to this beautiful lake. It's a pretty big lake. People paddleboard and canoe, fish. You can do everything but swim here, and you can't have a boat with a motor in it here. And there's houses that are on it. It's a really nice lake, and it's well maintained. And it's well known in North Asheville. I just heard a frog. Hey, frog. Ribbit. Maybe he'll croak again if we're quiet. He did. Did you hear it? I hope you heard it. Okay, Troy's gonna get the camera now and he's gonna tell us the ghost stories he told me in the car.
So I've read about some ghost stories here at Beaver Lake, and there's two of them that they're actually like, I guess people are just seeing like spirits or something like that, but they're not like a haunted situation where it's scary or anything. But they have seen a young man who they believe drowned himself in the 70s in this lake, and occasionally people will see him on the lake shore and just kind of just walking around. And also a young lady who they also believe had committed suicide in this lake. And they also have been reports of her looking into the lake and maybe contemplating what she did many years ago. Those are the two stories of this lake. I've not ever seen anything, but people have reported seeing these two ghostly like figures out on the lake. So if you're ever at Beaver Lake, keep your eye. You never know. And I tell you, the best thing to do is take your camera, video camera, when you're filming in places. Always go back and look and listen and see, because you'll most likely see something you missed, whether it be a ghost or maybe a bird flew by or something, or something you just missed. It's always fun to go back and look. But at Crossroads Explorers, we are going to explore all kinds of different things like this lake. We're going to explore places that are maybe a little ghostly haunted. We'll be doing that as well. But we're going to take you to places also that If you're in the Asheville area and Western North Carolina itself, we're going to be going and taking you places you might want to check out. So like and subscribe, as Marnie said, and put that little bell notification on, because when we upload videos, it's going to be a place that you might want to visit and check out for yourself. But it is a beautiful lake. It's very, very beautiful. This little pathway walk, or this little walkway here we're on, takes you to this part, and you can just see lake for miles is what it looks like. And it's just beautiful. And I have a friend of mine that fishes out here. And now this is a lake, though. If you fish, I want to let you know, if you fish at this lake, it's a catch and release. So if you're not a catch and release person, this may not be the place to fish for you. But if you are a catch and release person, this would be a great place for you to fish. People take paddle boats out and do stuff like that on this lake. But it's very, very beautiful. So you owe it to yourself, if you're in the Asheville area, to check out Beaver Lake. It's just right off of Merriman Avenue. You can't miss it. Once you get past all the grocery stores and stores like Stein Mart and Ingles, it'll be on your left if you're going towards the north. If you're coming the other direction south, and you it's the same. It's just beautiful. Just check it out, right off of Merriman Avenue, and see if you find a ghostly figure out here. For Crossroads Explorers, we'll catch you in our next video. God bless.